Hi everyone, it's Anya here. I'm back with another video for Ophelia Crafts. So today's video is all about our butterfly thinlets. They are not so easy to cut out with. You need to do a little bit of creative crafting sort of thing. So today I'm just going to show you what I do. Every big shot is different, I found out, because they kept saying this on the internet. I've got two big shots, so I did the same sandwich in my other big shot and it was different. So they are right, they are different. So let's see what I do. We have our multi-purpose platform, and what I do is I put in between the sheets, I have this lovely coloured felt. Don't ask me where I got that. I didn't get it myself. It's a horrible colour. Never mind. So I put that in between there because that's going to make it a little bit thicker. Then I have my first plate. Put that there. Then we talk about, people talk about dryer sheets and greaseproof paper. I have all that and I do use all that as well. So I have these little dryer sheets. They're from the pound shop. They don't even smell. So I don't know what they're going to do for your dryer, but I can use them very well. They're a little bit of, you know, they're a little bit folded up, but I open them up. So I put four together like that. Then I put my paper. This is just a scrap that I'm using. Then I put my greaseproof paper. I think the reason they're using this paper is for avoiding the little dots in the thinlet, okay, in your cutout bit. And then you have your plate. If your plates are a little bit bent like mine, make sure you put them down, bent side down. Do you know what I mean? So you're not having them hollow, because that of course is going to miss the thinlet. Make sure you put them down with the bent side so it's nice and sturdy. Okay, let's wheel this through, and your big shot is going to make all kinds of sounds, and let's see if this sandwich worked. If it hasn't, then we can also always put it through in the other direction just to be sure, and I think it has worked, but let's have a look. Are these things coming? See, this is what I do. I just check it. I think it's okay. So let's just take it all out. And some people have it all coming out just like that. It doesn't do that with mine. I don't know why or what I need to do more, but I've already put a lot in, I think, so I don't really want to start putting even more in. I don't mind doing this actually, so that's fine. So let's push it out. So some of these holes will be pushing into the onto the paper, and that's how you get your butterfly out, but I think that's okay. I can live with this. So now the good thing about this is, have a look, there's hardly any dots, so that's good. And okay, yeah, my bits came out quite easily, but what I also have is I have two butterflies. So I have a wax paper one and a paper one. And obviously, I'm not going to chuck this one. I'm going to keep it because I can do something with that. As we do. Crafters, we always can do something with everything. So this I'm going to use in my next card, so do stay tuned and look out for that next video. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And I thank you for watching. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time. Bye.